everyone, how are you children? Nowadays, we follow our listening lessons through digital classes. Let us learn our class, Unit 6th from 10th class, Biodiversity. Biodiversity, it refers to the variety and variability of life on Earth, includes plants, animals, and ecosystem, such as grassland, deserts, highland, tundra, polars, rainforest. Unfortunately, human activities greatly contribute to the loss of biodiversity. Some 20 or 30 years ago, we used to listen chirping sound of the cuckoos, parrots, crane, the pigeons. But now, we not found such a crane or the sparrows. Here are there. Crow is also disappearing. What happened to these animals because of human activities? Let us know some. For human needs and the increased use of technology to meet the role in the climate change, which continues to be a big threat to biodiversity. Destruction of habitat. The natural habitat of animals is destroying by man for the purpose of settlement, agriculture, mining, industries, construction of highways, and so on. As a result, the species must move to other places. If not, they become target to starvation, disease, and eventually die. Realizing this, the poetess Medora Chevalier expressed her feelings through this poem, "Or Will the Dreamer Wake?" The very title of the poem is interesting. It is a question arousing interest in the minds of the readers. It clearly depicts how certain species of animals are about to disappear. The dreamer is still dreaming about something. She has the dreamer would wake up and has to take the responsibility to making the good and natural atmosphere to the future generation. Now, about the author, Medora Chevalier. Medora Chevalier is a 21st century poet. She was born on July 19, 1907. And died in September 1995 at 88 years old. She is a lyricist, poet, choreographer and dancer, as well as a campaigner for social justice. She writes about contemporary themes. Here, our 10th student recites the poem. Let us listen the poem. First stanza.
Out in the east, the jungle listens. The tigress plaintive growls in pain. The great trees hear her breathing, shaking inside her still. The new life's weight. These cubs could be the last ones ever to freely live and roam and mate. A grandchild knows the tiger never, or will the dreamer wake?
Vocabulary: plaintive, sad, growls, deep sound, roam, to walk, mate, accompanied, shaking, not happy about something. The grandchild, people from our future generation. The dreamer, human being. Well, let us now discuss the direction mentioned here is east. East refers to the Asian continent. Medora Chevalier says that land is depleting because of man's deeds, that is, cutting down forests. Though the poetess mentioned only tiger species, she is referring to all the animals that live in the forest. Here the tigress which was about to give birth to cubs would be the victim of being on the list of endangered species. Its painful sounds can be heard by the trees, which are the witnesses to the extinction of the tigress, and its cubs too can be the last ones to leave freely roam and mate. Chevalier also says that the future generation will never know the tiger because they will be extinct by them. She has the dreamers, that is, humans, if they will realize how they are destroying the environment, she asks us to save the environment before it is too late.
Far in the north, the white bear snuffles down in her lair the gleaming snow. She waits for all the life she's making outside the crashing glacier's crow. These cubs could be the last cubs ever to freely live and roam and mate. Our grandchild knows the white bear never, or will the dreamer wait?
Vocabulary: snuffles, breathe noisily, lair, resting place, gleaming, shining, crashing, collage, glaciers, snow moves slowly down a mountain. Now, far in the north, polar region, the polar white bear is taking kick ass in her den and is waiting to take great care about its baby that is to be born, because the glacier's large mass of ice is getting destroyed. The man is causing the destruction. Due to global warming, temperature is going to be increasing. Results, the snow mountains are melting day by day. The white bear survives in the gleaming snow. The glaciers are decreasing or getting destroyed. So the white bear snuffles for its existence. The poet conveys through this line that the white bear is also in the list of endangered species as the environment is degrading, and the white bear waits for all the life she is making for the rehabilitating of the environment.
There is the west, the song thrush warbles, she weaves her nest to hold her clutch. A long wait now to find a partner, the eggs are laid, there are not much. These chicks could be the last ones ever, the last to fly and sing and mate. Our grandchild knows the song thrush never, or will the dreamer wait?
Vocabulary: clutch, hold or grip, laid, lay, partner, mate. In the west, a noisy thrush warbler is also endangered species by the poet. The female thrush warbler weaves her nest and stays in it and waits for its mate. After finding its mate, the female thrush warbler laid eggs and hatched them. As the thrush warblers and their chicks too are facing extinction, therefore they cannot fly, sing and mate. The poet is trying to get message out by using the phrase, our grandchild knows never. Hence the poet is questioning whether dreamer will wake to conserve the endangered species thrush warbler from extinction.
Deep in oceans how the whale swims, her song of birthing fills the seas. Thousands of creatures wait the moment the solemn bird they will see. This child could sing the final whale song, the last to make the oceans shake. Our grandchild never hears its mystery, or will the dreamer wake?
Vocabulary: birthing fills, giving birth to a baby, solemn, not happy or serious, mystery, reason, or impossible to understand. In the south, The whale is the creator, lives in the Antarctic region. The human beings dump all kinds of waste into rivers, lakes and seas, causing water pollution. This affect the plants and animals living in the water. A whale in the deep South Ocean swims across the ocean with a song of giving birth to its calls. Thousands of creatures witness the glorious moments become momentary because the whales and its calls too are facing the extinction. Therefore, the baby whales could not swim, sing and shake the ocean. So the poet is trying to message the dreamer will wake up to conserve the endangered species whale from extinction. If not, a grandchild knows never the face of species whale.
Here is the center for directions, gather the path that leads up or down. Is this a last bright new world birthing? Is this a waving as we drown? This could be a lost true moment, knowing the truth our choices make. A grandchild asks, that was the moment and did the dreamer wake?
Vocabulary: path, the way, leads, go, bright new, expected, drawn, immerse in water. Far in the center of the four directions, the path head is filled with ups and downs. Some of the animals and the birds are vanished from the world. On knowing the truth, this may be our waving as we drown, because only few species are in the list of endangered species at present. The poet says we have to make right choices. Then at that time, our grandchildren ask that was a moment and whether the man work to conserve the endangered species. The poet opinions that if you do not take much care, the next generation will have them in their dreams only. Here is figures of speech, literary devices. Writer uses such phrases or words to get effectiveness in their writings or literary device. Rhetorical question. When a question is asked for effectiveness and not to get any answer, it is called rhetoric. Example, or will the dreamer wake? Here, the poet questions the dreamer awake to conserve the endangered species for future generation. The poet asks question and not to get any answer, so it is rhetorical type of question. Next, personification. It is when an object which is not alive is given human qualities. Example, the great trees hear her breathing. Here the great trees are plants. These are represented as human being and given the qualities of hearing. So it is a personification. Next, exclamation. When a strong feeling is expressed, it is called exclamation. Example, that was a moment. Our grandchildren asked that was a moment that their sudden feelings are expressed. Our exclamation and end by exclamatory mark. Children, have studied in our previous class a letter from Mother Earth. She asked us to protect forests, mountains. Mountain helps to make rain and keep life on earth going. We humans are ourselves destroying our bountiful forest, animal species and making land barren. Mother Earth has wished us when we all grew up and become good citizens would take care of her. So keep the promise of Mother Earth. Here is assignment. Write a letter to Mother Earth, take an oath to conserve the endangered species and restore life to the degraded environment which rehabilitates all the species.